Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler, and welcome to another episode of Farming Simulator 17. We are in Goldcrest Valley waiting for some kind of a weather change. Still wondering how this all works. About 3 in the morning, we got a notice of that cloud with the white dots coming out, which I'm guessing is kind of a hail symbol. But nothing's happened yet, so we'll see what happens at the 6-hour mark at 9 a.m. Otherwise, we've got some equipment to clean up. Got our all of our planting done, and both rounds of planting, this one and the one over there, have the fertilizer applied at the same time, so there'll be nothing to do till the next growth stage. So let's go get this guy put away. I always wonder as I go through here, am I lined up right? Oh, got it. And this one does need seed put in it, so let's go ahead and take care of that while we're at it. Oh, those backup skills. Something like that. All right, refill him. Okay, let's get this a little bit closer to where it belongs. This way. Like so, and nope. I really need to do this from inside. All right, we'll try this again. Whoa! Weather changed on us. That's what I was seeing and not getting. Alright, let's pull out here, get this guy parked. Something like that. Actually, you know what? Let's see if it gets cleaned. I'm curious to see if it will. Let's just turn this off. Now what have we got here? I'm seeing white dots. I don't think the rain looks like this, so I think that is hail. Turn my volume up. Yeah, kind of a tink, tink, tink sound. I think it's a hailstorm. There's the wind. Wow. Kind of ominous. Kind of want to hide in here. Get the rain kind of blasting through. Okay. Well, let's get this one in. We'll brave the weather here. Hopefully the chickens got inside. Is that looking any cleaner? That's a little dirty. Which button is it? There it is. Oh, boy, that's loud. Turn that back down. Alright, I think that's getting cleaned. It is. Tractor's looking a little better, too. Should we drag everything out and give everything a washing? That might be something to do. This one needs... I'm pretty sure that's seed. And it's open. Okay, that's full. Leave this outside. And let's kind of verify. Although these two haven't been dirtied at all yet. This one probably wasn't going to be showing much dirt. What here does? Kind of a free car wash day. You're looking okay already. Let's head up to the cultivator. See if that needs to be drug out and cleaned up. The plow we already cleaned. Or the cultivator we already cleaned. The plow hasn't been used. That stuff's all clean. How's this guy? It's almost like it's Well, no, this guy could be put outside. Okay. It's bath day at the farm. There we go. Nope, that's the wrong button. Let's go over to the trailers. Have to drive on the new seed there. We've got a sunny day coming out ahead of us here. Oh, I just realized I turned the time down when I got started kind of piddling around. In fact, I turned on the game and my pedals didn't work. So I had no way to accelerate or brake other than the keyboard. So I turned the computer on and off a couple times. That didn't work. These guys are... they're looking fine enough. And is this tractor getting clean, though? I'm only guessing this is working. I'm thinking it's working at a very slow rate. There's still a little bit of dirt on there, but let's go look at that original sower. That thing should be spotless by now, if this is going to work. If not, we'll go put all this stuff away. But restarted the computer twice, still had no pedals, so got into the controls and basically just looked at everything. I didn't change anything, and then I went back to run the game and it worked. So I don't have an explanation as to why it works. I really didn't change anything. It happened once before, a few weeks back. So this guy is, I think, cleaner than it was. I don't know. I'm thinking this is not working. Okay, let's call that experiment a failure. All right, you're going to go into the corner. Straight in. And turn in like that. Right about there. We'll leave him out here. And put this guy away. We're pretty well lined up already. We'll try it like this. See, into there. Yep, into there. Something like that. Yeah, that wants to look like snow, huh? Alright, what next? Pickup truck's outside. It's still looking just as dirty as before. Yeah, I'm thinking this is not going to clean things. So, we'll give up on that idea. So, what else do we drag out? Really, it was just the combine. Okay, let's go put this away then. That matter, let's get time sped up a little further so we can get through this point and get off to whatever's next. Right there. Boy, it is really coming down now. I'm stuck. Climb over the tractor. Combine up there. Let's drive the pickup up there. And I am soaked by now, all this rain. Whoa! Okay, we're going this way. Look down to find the seat to get myself in the cab, and I turned a lot further than I expected. Yeah, this place is still a mess. Alright, let's get up here, put this guy away. Well, it was a good experiment. Failed miserably, but Good to know. Alright. This bay is going to be where we'll park the sugar beet harvester, too. Yeah. And the trailer for the headers is out over there with the trailers. That's right. Alright, back in the pickup. And what? Well, let's kick speed up even faster. Time up. And let's drive out to the... it just stopped. 2 hour storm. Okay. Take you back down to 5 speed. There we are. And let's drive out there and work on some grass. I think. Let me check the harvest schedule here. Growth. You are now, we have advanced by one cycle. You are now the last stage of growth on our beets. These guys are down in here. I think just at the planted stage, right? Because they both were sowed at the same time. So they should be coming in at the same time. All right. So withered. We drive down here. Yeah, these guys are still withered. Okay. Unfortunately, the big one is withered. That's too bad because that's going to require plowing. That's like a 3 hour plowing job in real time even. Oh, I'm not looking forward to that one. But I'm pretty sure that will drop a big chunk back into our bank account if I do it. Yeah, let's jump back in the cab and let's go look at our mower. Let's go look at the beets first. I wonder if I'll ever see a mod for something like not a golf cart, not a four-wheel quad, but something between those two. Kind of putter around on the farm with without getting into the pickup truck. Alright, let's hop out here. A little taller than last time? I think so. That should be the last stage. Okay. Well, let's head over to the field 11. Got our mowing equipment over there already. And verify that last stage finally went to full growth. That last section. If so, we'll make this a mowing episode. I guess we'll mow everything and windrow it. We can go back later and either use the loading wagon to bring a bunch of it over to the silage bays, or let's see here, or we can bring the tedder over and tedder some of it. Boy, this thing just jumps. All right, let's try this again. It looks like it's done. I think so. Let's hop in here and pull all the way out. Yep. We've got ourselves a meadow. Nice. Now, my field of vision, or my whatever you call it, to how far out you can look before it renders. Depth of render? I don't know what the term is. Must not be set very high. Because I thought I would be able to see most of this entire field. But that's right, I was playing with the settings trying to figure out why it was getting laggy at 1 hour. Never did solve that. I thought I had at one point, but I didn't. So when it dies at 1 hour, I know my episode's over. Anyway, let's get this guy going. How best? What is our plan? I guess we'll just kind of cut this field in half right here. Let's see, I'm going to get to where... I'm going to get inside. This one, I want to be able to respond quickly when it changes. Yeah, like that. That'll do. Yeah, all right. So, where am I? Let's X and V and B that one. G, X... This is a slow one. V and B. Ooh, like the sounds. This guy. Right? No. There we go. He extends out. And we'll go forward a little bit before we drop him down on the railroad tracks. All right, what is straight? That's not straight. Something like that. Okay, drop him into there. V and B. There they are. And back into the cab, and let's see what we're doing. Though I guess this would be easier from outside. Yeah, something like that. Now I'm gonna go a little bit past. There we go. Alright then. Let's go around the perimeter of everything. Sheep were needing a cleanup too. So maybe while we're on this part of the map, we'll take care of them. Now, what to do here? I think I'm going to try. I'm going to skirt into these trees a bit. Without banging into anything. That's not too bad. None of this was the original field, so we're going to take advantage of the rest of the land in the area. That's kind of why I picked this one. There was enough other land around to be able to do that. And yeah, we're going to chop up that middle line. That's fine. They'll all become rows. Probably, yeah, all in this direction. But there may be little fragments of the line left behind that'll let us know where the halfway point was later. One thing about this, I don't have to be all that precise. We miss a little bit here and there. We're not going to notice much in the way of yield, and it's not going to look bad, unlike leaving a bunch of corn stalks behind. Just enjoy this. Now, I don't believe this is something that the game is capable of hiring out. Verify that. Shouldn't be an H. Oh, there is an H. Hire worker. What would that do? It wouldn't do a very good job. What are you doing? Stop, stop, stop. I don't know what he thought he was doing. Okay, I go back to saying that I don't believe this is a job that you can hire a worker. Okay, how do you recover from this? Let's get back over here. That'll be good enough. Okay, start over. VB. GVB, GVB. B. B. I think they're all gone. Let's see if we have three paths of grass in there. Do we have the middle one? We do. Okay. Alright, learned that lesson. But I had to find out. Now, unfortunately, we're going to jog every time we get to this middle point. Yeah. Hear that? As we hit more grass, it slowed down. As we cleared the grass, it sped up. It knows when it's under a load. Wow. That wasn't the case in previous versions. $7 wages. We paid $7 for that mess up. Okay, so let's dive in a row. Something like that. we'll just push our way through at 11-ish miles an hour. And this diagonal at this end is going to nip us in the butt later, but it'll be fine. Make sure everything is doing what it's supposed to. Looks like it. Okay. Further that way. Yep, that looks good. So we lost a little bit on the edge there. So I wonder what flowers are in there. I'm trying to remember what the blue ones were called. Used to know it. At least something that looks just like that. Used to go hiking a lot, see those meadows. 7 miles an hour up the hill. So I noticed that Night Ghost put out a new series today on Banished. And I'd forgotten what it's like to see 300 views on a video. I tell you, you folks like Banished. When I look back at the last 48 hours of my channel, there's a real-time option. Shows you real-time for 48 hours. And go through all the videos that are the most views in the last 2 days. It's almost always loaded with Banished. Usually there's whatever I release today of either RimWorld or Farming Simulator at the top, and then maybe what I released the day before. Then after that, it's all Ramblington or George or Noble Landing. So that's still the primary game that people are watching on my channel, and I think Vapas and Night Ghost the same way. So Banish has still really got everyone's attention. Is interesting. I've played it so much in the last year, I'm burnt out. I've turned Noble Landing on a couple of times and sat there and stared at it trying to figure out where to go next. And this feeling of dread comes over me, like I just don't want to play this anymore. So I'm hoping a month or two off and it'll start to feel fresh again. And I'll be able to finish off Noble Landing. And then I'm thinking about maybe more of a vanilla Banished series, something that I haven't done since the very beginning of my channel. I started off with a series of Dungeon Siege. It was an old vintage game, and Banished, just the vanilla version of Banished, no mods or anything, and that was a lot of fun. And I need to get back into Dungeon Siege. I need to stall off an end here. I was losing the corners back there. But Dungeon Siege, I want to get back into. I purposely stopped right in the middle because I was 50 episodes into that and I wanted to get into other games. But I promised to get back in and finish that. So that was one of the games I wanted to get back into this winter. Going to get that series completed. But yeah, I'm thinking maybe a vanilla Banished series to get me back into it. One thing about the Mega Mod, while there's so many choices, which is a bonus, also there's so many choices, which is what goes against you. You sit there trying to figure out how to be fair to all the different options rather than just build your two or three favorite houses, and you get so overwhelmed that it feels like a burden almost. So, I have to get my mind wrapped around. I wonder if there's a better way to do this. I wonder if I curved around, came back like this. That might be better, because it's hard to make those corners. Your mowers are on an outside arc, and your windrower is on an inside arc, and so they're not lining up properly. So we'll do this the rest of the way. But, like I mentioned last time, I'm also having fun with Astroneer just on my own time. So that one, when it grows up just a little bit more, That's right. Tomorrow there is a dev stream on that game on Twitch, where they're looking at a new space station that they're building for the game. That maybe you can visit when you launch from the planet. I don't know. And all that's going to be involved there. So I might try to tune into that, see what that is, but also just get a sense of where they're going with the game. All right, these ends are going to be a little bit messy. Might go through afterward and just run the ends one more time, and that'll kind of clean up all the corners. Am I looking at it from the outside? Yep, I'm good. But many episodes ago when we had the poll and it was chosen to buy this field and grass it out, so if we're finally getting back to, we just got distracted with a few fields that were ready to harvest right there in between, and then had to get them planted again and had to get them fertilized, and the other one popped and had to deal with that one, and so finally back to this. Get the silage going, get it fermenting, get it sold, and that should fund our bank account again pretty well. It worked really well in 13 and 15. I've heard that 17 has really toned down what you make on silage, so that might not be the case now. Remember back on Farming Simulator 2013, I used to do this, except I had, I think it was a single mower and the loading wagon behind, and I would just drive all the county roads and just load up the loading wagon with grass and haul it down to the biogas plant and sell it all off, and then head off and get another load. And I had 2 or 3 bays of silage cooking at all times, and I made more money than I knew what to do with. And with that, I was able to buy so many of the farm, or the fields. Kept all of those planted, and whenever something wasn't ready to harvest, then I was out mowing again. Back then, you only fertilized once, and you didn't have to plow at all. So I just skipped those steps, just fertilized one time, and that was it. And you fertilized just as it planted. Well, kind of like you do here with the silver that fertilizes as well. But then you just had to wait for it to be ready to harvest. There's no other steps to do. So either contracted out jobs. And in that game, it was different. You would contract out kind of like for the city or for the county. Let me clean up this over here. You would mow the baseball diamond or the drive-in theater or someone's private property that a realtor needed you to clean up so that it would sell. That kind of a thing. So you grab a mower and go and do those. Or there were pallet fork jobs where someone needed something hauled from here to there. So there was a big job board, and you'd go there and look for jobs that had been posted. And it paid ridiculously well. A couple of those jobs, you can buy a tractor. So it was really out of balance, but it was just something to do. So this one, the contracting jobs at the fields, that's new to this version. I've never had that before. And with the silage being lowered in its value, then there really isn't as much emphasis to go through and cut all the grass on the map. All right. I have no idea how well the windrower is catching everything back there. We'll probably be if the ends are all kind of messed up anyway, maybe that's what we will tether. That makes sense. Let's mess it up further. But actually, we got through this mowing awfully quick. And one more pass and then some cleanup to do. And for the most part, 11 miles an hour all the way through. Okay, what's the plan? The looking pretty good over here. I don't think I need to get to the other side of the dirt road. A little bit out there in the middle. And the ends need it, and there's a lot of trees on the other side of the road, so I might just skip that. Yeah, the big rock there too. So let's kind of merge all this back together again with the windrower. Slowly arc our way over to these patches over here. Oh, turn and catch that one. We're good there. There's one patch in the middle. Let's go see what that was all about. We'll catch the end over there, then we'll turn the equipment off. I'm just going to make a mess as far as the windrower, but that'll be fine too. I could turn all the equipment off and drive faster to these spots, but there's a lot of buttons to push to do that. So I'm just going to patiently take my time. Alright, I see something in front of me to the left, just a little bit to the right. Yeah. Windrower we can keep over here. There's no point in keeping the mowing equipment over here, right? Well, there actually is. But we need a place to put it, keep it out of the weather. Alright, we're going to call this done. Let's see, BG, BG, B. I did it. All right. VG, VG, VG? Not quite. Nope. I see. At some points, the front one works in tandem with the back one, and sometimes it doesn't. Huh. Well, X, G, X, G, X. That worked. We're in the air. Okay. So what do we do with this stuff? What do we do with this stuff? Let's think about this. Where do we put some sheds? Over here, we're kind of sloped and we're kind of crowded. A lot of trees and rocks. So let me get to where I can... get to where I can see over here. Do we do something over in this area? Right over there between those two trees. Do we do something at the end over there? The end over there just has enough room to turn the tractor around if we ever go through and plow this again. Let's go over there. Because that's going to be hard to put a shed right there and still be able to mow in front of the trees like that. Now this area here, we do some turning around as well. But not as far as over there by those rocks. Let's look at this. Double click. Now how much... This guy. I don't think we need this much or this much. 20,000 is a lot to spend, too. This guy would probably do it. There was one more. Whoa, 100,000 for that one. That looks like the one that was in Westbridge Hills. I'm thinking so. You drove into it, it's just this huge garage and had plows and cultivators and sowers. I mean, this thing was just full of equipment. And one of these days, we do need to get into the greenhouses. As soon as we get a good supply of manure, which we don't really have yet. Sheep don't make it, I don't believe. No, that's only pigs and cows, and really it's cows for the most. You could put power supplies up. You've got an extra $1 million to dump into something, and this will give you a constant income. This one too, but this one most likely 8 times, 9 times as much if it's proportional to its price. And then you've got some decorations, picnic shelters, You've got all the different buildings that are scattered around, bunch of trees, and this guy, which is what we used at the sheep, which was an inexpensive one, smaller. I like the look of that, but it was actually kind of hard to get much in there. These a lot of posts. Let's go back. I think this guy, 9,000 by, oh good, I'm glad it started right here. That is good sized though. Let's see, is Q and E turn it around? I hope, yes. But he is big. And he doesn't like the rocks or the hills or something, and that doesn't give us enough room. Okay, can I rotate myself? How do you turn your camera? Shift E? No, that goes faster. Control E? Nope. How do I look over here? So if I hit escape and P, nope, don't do that. Rotate my own camera around. That big one's not going to fit. I think it's what it would come down to. It's just not going to fit. So we are the next size. Yeah, that's too hilly over there. We have a smaller one right where those bushes are, or a smaller one right back there by the rocks. Okay, try this again. I'm pretty sure there is a way, though, to rotate the map while you're doing this, but I don't know what it is. Okay, so this guy, I think that's where we're going instead. Buy this one and rotate him around. Shift button speeds him up. Go back. That guy in there seems kind of wimpy. Or I'd like to go over here. Well, I guess I can go like this and see what I'm doing. Something like that. I want to get to where I can see if he's actually parallel. But as soon as I move my mouse there, he moves. And I can't rotate my camera. So he's probably going to go in a little bit crooked. Do we do that? What's the furthest back it'll let me go? Right there. And if I go into that tree, I'm pretty sure that the tree will... No, it will not let that tree delete. It'll let you delete bushes, but it's not going to let you delete a tree. Okay. Kind of a permanent choice here, a decision here. You can't really move these guys afterwards. I think you can only sell them. And if I don't set it on a bush, then it will leave that bush sitting right in front of it. So I think we're going for right about there. And a second one right there. Nope, got a tree there. Cannot be placed there. And I still cannot, right-click and hold? No, I cannot spin my map. So, let's just go with that for now. Escape and P for shop. And that's where we will drop, and it did not delete the plant. I thought it would. It did for the one over by the sheep. I guess I didn't get 100% of it inside or something. Well, he's just going to be there. So let's put the mower away in there. Something like that. And G to the front. And Q. Don't you fall over. This guy... What is the next plan? Tell you, let's back him in. And we'll come back for him if we need him. Need to go get the tether. Okay. Let's take this nice and slow. There. Nope. Okay. That's looking pretty good. Alright. And a little bit further back. So turn that way. All right, we're good. All right, let's go grab the tether. And where am I out of my time? About 40 minutes. Okay. Tether and what? Baler. So tether on the front, baler on the back. Just get the equipment over here. Nobody coming that way? It's probably good that they didn't have those rows line up perfectly. We would just be shooting across this thing and not care about traffic. Now, I sped up time, or the growth rate to get to where the grass was going to be working. Now we're going to slow it back down. Back. Because we just advanced, which means we may already be ready to... where's my map? Remove tops. Aha. Let's go get that started. I think we'll hire that part out. We'll probably hire most of it out, because that is a frustratingly narrow piece of equipment that you'll go back and forth far more times than you really want to admit to. Let's go look at it. So it's saying that it has... Let's go this way. They've matured underneath, and we need to wipe the tops out and then dig them up. So let's start that process on another tractor, and then we'll hire out the rest of it. You can be doing that while we're playing with grass. Whoa, yep. Try it again. Squeak through. All right. Let's just park this guy. Let me think here. Put him there. What did... This does require a PTO takeoff. Yeah, let's see what we've got. Let's head to our garage. There we go. And find that equipment right there. You require only 75 horsepower. Okay. Then no problem. We'll grab old Blue here. And front or back? You usually see it in the front. And is this guy on wheels? He is, but is that for travel only? Do we need to wait? When he's running, he will be on the wheels. Now, we go forward. Slam the brakes. It doesn't drop the tractor down or tip it forward. Okay, so don't really need to wait on this. Okay, let's head up here. Here. We'll drive it to the center of the field and hop out again. So let's drop him down. There is no unfolding, right? Right. B turns him on. And we'll go forward a little bit here and watch what happens. He just kind of shreds it all up. Where does he toss it? Throws it behind like a push lawnmower. And shears it all off, leaves the beets down there for the next piece to go through and pull them up. So, yeah, let's go ahead and drive him out to this end here. And then we'll hire him out. Make sure we don't miss that little row back there. Let's go ahead and take it to this point here. And hire. Okay. You do that. This guy, let's see what he needs as soon as we get out of that noise. Shop. Garage. We're not in the same place. All right, do that again. You require 134. Okay, so the case tractors are 145s. They'll be able to handle this guy. But I can't let him run because I've got to dump him. All right, that's going to wait. We're going to get back to what we were doing. Next time we will start harvesting beets. I want to get, really, these three pieces of equipment over there. Nothing else goes over there, right? Well, the loading wagon will at some point. Yeah. But only one has a three-point hitch. So let's do that here. If I can get the right angle in there. Right there. Well, that's pretty close.
It's close enough?
It's close enough. Okay, so him on front. And I think the baler on the back. Where are you? Oh, got a long way to go. There we go. All right, let's haul this over. And we'll go this way and kind of peek at this, see how he's doing. Looks like he's already come back on the next row. Don't see anything missed in there. Good. Okay. Looks like we may just get all the equipment hauled today. Don't know if we're going to get a lot done. We're running it into the end of the episode. Now we could tether in front and windrower in the back and get rows of hay really quick, but realistically you tether it and let it sit out in the sun for a while. So it makes sense that we should probably tether maybe right now, so that when we come back next episode it'll feel like it's been out there kind of cooking and drying. You can see where we cut across. Got mounds piled up there where it doubled up in its height. So let's toss the baler. It would be nice to have a second shed out here. Second lean-to. Really would. What if we went over there, wherever those bushes are? Let's do that. Placeables. This guy. Bye. Can we go here? I think we can. So what do I want? E. And if I do this, I can get my parallel. There. There, that looks pretty good. And where specifically? I think right there. And a little closer to the road. Don't want those bushes in there. Yeah, we'll do something like that. Actually, there's really no way to know that I'm at the same depth as the other one. I guess we'll roll the dice right there. And escape, back. How does that look? That's pretty good. Dang. Yeah, well, not exact. Not quite like dropping a laser across there, but pretty darn close. Okay, let's get the baler put away. And let's go do some quick tethering. Tethering? Let's ted this thing. Let's see, I want to be something like that. You gonna make that? Not really. Well, go a little further and straighten out. Okay. Yeah, the shorter the tongue on it, the more sensitive it is to oversteering. Yeah, we're getting it. Let's get a little bit more distance in there. Takes a while for those tractor tires to make their turn. I wish if I zoomed in a little I could see it better. Ah. You live right there. Where's Q? There it is. Okay. Let's put this on the back. Where are you? There you are. That wasn't it. That one. Okay, what do we do? Let's do the ends. Here, just kind of spread that out. We'll run over this a few times and spread it out real good. Now, how tight of a turn can I make? Well, that's not bad. Kind of catch some of this and spread out a little bit more. Problem is, it's going to spread into the grass and mix with the grass right, you know, side by side. So I don't know what the windrower is going to do. If it's going to be able to differentiate one or the other, or just what's going to happen. So we have to do this kind of smart. You know, breaking it right there. Let's pull into here and break it there. And we'll just have to try to hit these other ones just right. Go ahead and take one more pass in here. Then we'll head over and try the... Yeah, let's not hit that clump. I like that. Let's head over and try the other side, wherever it got all messed up. Let's spread this around a little bit more, make sure it dries really well. Alright, V. And B. Let's floor it over here. Mess this end up over here where it's already messed up. Okay. V and B. We could do a little bit in there, but I think we're fine keeping on this side of the road. This doesn't spread it out as far as I had originally assumed. Still trying to keep it in some kind of a trail behind us. Maybe the second pass helps to do it. I guess I'm used to doing this right after the mowing instead of windrowing in between. That's what's causing the difference. One more pass will clip off the ends of all of those. Is that a wise plan? I think so. Kind of a natural break right there. Yeah, we'll just have to very carefully separate these two kinds of clippings at these points, because there's no other natural breaks in there. Alright, well, there's enough to get us some hay bales. And I think we'll call this one done at this point. So we've got hay bales. We'll bale some of the grass for grass bales. Some of those we will wrap for silage bales. And then the rest we will haul off to the silage pits to put under cover and ferment. Probably 2 episodes from now, depending on how long the beets take to finish off. Put this guy away, won't be using him again for a while. Much easier when it's not a trailer. Alright, you park in there. V and Q, and I think we'll drive this one back. Otherwise, we're going to end up with too many vehicles dropped off in this field. Got the pickup truck sitting over here too. And we need to drive the wrapper back. So we gotta get at least one of these vehicles over here. Got a truck on the road over there. So that's the other truck that's in the game that you can buy. I think we're gonna stick with our vintage pickup over there. I like the look of that. Let's go see how the beet topper is doing. We'll call this one done. Coming up on, what's 1500, 3 p.m.? I'll have to check to see if this game will switch to normal hours. I think it does. We're almost halfway done over here. Yeah, I'm doing a good job. Okay, let's put this guy away and call this one done, and I'll catch you next time. Something like that. All right. Yep, this is an episode. So, see you later, folks. Bye-bye.